everyone, thank you so much for tuning in today and welcome to the home of FIFA career mode hints, tips and news. If you are new to my channel, I would be eternally grateful if you would hit that subscribe button. If you're already a subscriber, welcome back and thanks for your continued support. And in today's video, I will be sharing with you a few of my favourite tips to help you enjoy a long and successful Road to Glory career mode. Now, Road to Glory career mode is where you start off in a lower league and work your way up to reach the pinnacle of the top division, like the Premier League, and even win the Champions League. So the first tip is to please excuse my spelling mistake and then choose your team wisely. Now you're going to be at this club for a very long time, so I always use one of three factors. I like an authentic stadium, I like a couple of players that have got a decent potential, but most importantly, I like a team with a healthy budget. Now personally, I don't class a second division career mode as a road to glory. I much prefer to drop into the third division, so that does kind of limit you to the German third division and English League One. A couple of good options in the German third division though are Bayern 2, but my favourite is Ingolstadt. They've got a decent transfer budget of 4.3 million, a couple of players in the late 70s with their potential, and not a bad couple of kits as well. But one tip you will definitely not see in this video is to use a financial takeover. I do find that a little bit too easy and can build a pretty decent squad straight from the word go. So now let's look at a couple of teams who we can use in the English League One. Now there are four teams I like to use in League One. The first one being Ipswich. Dizel and Downs both have an 81 potential and a transfer budget of 2.4 million. Now the second team in League One do not have a particularly high budget, but they do have one of the highest growing young players in FIFA 20. And that's Peterborough, and the player is Ricky J. Jones, who grows a massive plus 25. The third team is Portsmouth, simply because Fratton Park is officially licensed in the game, and the same reason I also like Sunderland, because the Stadium of Light is also officially licensed and they've got a very healthy transfer budget of just under 5 million. So once you've decided which team you're going to use in your Road to Glory career mode, the second tip is to loan in some high potential youngsters. Now this is a short term fix, especially useful for teams with a low budget. So the way to do this is to go into the player search option, click the transfer status to for loan, the age range between 16 and 20. If you want to bring in younger players, then it's a matter of searching through the top leagues to see if there are any players you can bring in on loan in the first season in this Road to Glory career mode. Sadly, there's no one of much note in the Premier League in this particular career mode. So now let's move on to Ligue 1. And it's very easy to look up player potentials by using my partner website Ultra FIFA. But offhand, I know that Jan Gohobo does have a potential of 83 and Rio Griffiths has a potential of 80. But these five players that the ones I found all available to bring in on loan in season number one of this particular career mode and could all make a massive difference for a third division team when doing a Road to Glory. But one thing I wouldn't do with any of the players that you do loan in is train them up to get their overall any higher. If you do want to bring them in permanently, it will increase their value. So the third tip is quite similar, and that is to search for high potential release clauses. What that does is it kind of gets round the unwilling to relocate issue that we sometimes get in FIFA 20 career mode. So this time when you're searching for the player, the transfer status needs to be release clause. The age range can remain the same between 16 and 20. And it's again a matter of scrolling through the top leagues to try and find any young high potential players who have a release clause. Now I was lucky enough to find a couple of my personal favourite high potential youngsters available with a release clause in this career mode. Those being Martin van der Voort, the goalkeeper from Genk, who has a potential of 85. And Jesus Ferreira, one of my favourite backup strikers in career mode, who's got a potential of 85 and available to sign for £3.6 million in this career mode with a release clause. And just to reiterate what I said earlier, players who do have a release clause gets round the unwilling to relocate issue that we sometimes get in FIFA 20 career mode. So the two players that I bought in this Ingolstadt Road to Glory is Jesus Ferreira and Martin van der Voort. And the final two Road to Glory tips are all about generating funds that you can add to your transfer budget. And the first one is to use a scout, a future star. That's obviously if you're lucky to have any of these still available at this point in FIFA 20 career mode. You will need to purchase it from the EA catalogue. I'm lucky enough to have got quite a few still left, So there you go, scout a future star, and what this will do is send your scouts out to find a decent youth academy player. The intention is then to train him up pretty highly and to sell him on for a massive profit without even playing too many games for the first team. It's nice to see the youth academy name pool having so much variation in the surnames, but it's Adrien de France we're not looking at the minute. That will come in later on in the video. Simon de France is a scouted future star, 60 overall, potential range 84 to 94. Promoting him through to the senior team, it has potential to be special, meaning his overall will eventually achieve a 91 plus. He's got pretty good attributes for someone who's so young. 4-star skills, 3-star weak foot, but the intention is to train him up and to sell him on for a massive profit, just like I did right at the start of season number 2, selling him to Celtic for 16.5 million. And if you are using a low budget team, 16.5 million can make a massive difference for your squad building plans for the upcoming season. And the final tip is very similar to the scouted future star one. We're going to train up a youth academy goalkeeper and sell on for a massive profit. So I scouted Adrien de France when he was only 15 years of age, overall range of 52 to 70, potential range of 67 to 91. Being only 15, we can't promote him through to the senior team, but it does give us a full year to train him up and increase that value. So here he is at 16 years of age with an overall of 72, value of 2.4 million, and being 16, we can now promote him through to the senior team, where I continue to train him and manage to sell him on for a massive profit of 8.7 million. Again, this is a lot of money if you're using a third division team. So I've combined all these tips. I'm currently in the Championship in season number 2 with Sunderland, so I thought I'd share with you the players that I've bought in to this Sunderland Road to Glory career mode. I play with a 3-5-2 formation, and most of the players now, as you can see there, are all my own players. Martin van der Voort showing great potential, overall of 72. Manuel Rojo, 72, showing great potential. Nicolo Armini, 70 overall, showing great potential. Kumbula actually lost his potential status when I signed him down to at club sins. Gvardiol gone the opposite way, is now an exciting prospect. Nathan Collins, 67 overall, showing great potential. By selling the scouted future star, I raised enough funds to bring in Gustavo Asuncao, showing great potential with a 74 overall. Simon Soame lost his potential status when I signed him. Alan Velasco, again, he's gone the opposite way. He's an exciting prospect with an overall of 71. Arvin Epeira is also an exciting prospect, overall of 68. Gravenberch, exciting prospect, overall of 72. Lowadees, 70 overall, an exciting prospect. Billy Gilmore, 69 overall, showing great potential. Sante Hansen, exciting prospect with a 71 overall. Openda, exciting prospect, striker, 75 overall. Stephen Plaza, showing great potential, overall of 74. Adam Idar, 69 overall, showing great potential. And finally, Jesus Ferreira, 73 overall, exciting prospect. However, the main tip when doing a road to glory is simply be patient. Don't try and do too much too early. But by using any of these 5 tips, it should ensure you a long and successful road to glory career mode. So all that remains to say is thank you so much for watching. Please remember to tune into my channel next time for more FIFA 20 career mode content. But for today, it's FCG out.